So here in this video I'm going to discuss expectation value of x square. For a particle bound like electron in a 1D box, I'm going to calculate the expectation value of x square. Okay, so we know that if an electron bound in a 1D box of length 0 to a of infinite height, the wave function for this electron is psi is equal to the normalized wave function. Psi is equal to root 2 by a into sin pi x by a, and psi square is equal to root 2 by a into sin pi x divided by a. Expectation value of x square is equal to integration psi star x square sin dx, and the box length is 0 to a, take the limits as 0 to a. So now x square is equal to integration 0 to a, psi star is equal to root 2 by a, okay, so root 2 by a sin pi x divided by a into x square sin root 2 by a into sin pi x divided by a into dx. Next, so is equal to root 2 by a, and root 2 by a is a constant, take that outside. Root 2 into root into root 2, the root square, square and the root 2 can get cancel, remaining is 2 by a into integration 0 to a, okay, integration 0 to a, and sin pi x, sin into sin, sin square, and that x square into sin square pi x divided by a, so this is square, sin square into pi x by a into dx. Okay, next, so expectation value of x square is equal to 2 by a. So first we have to take convert this x sin square into some trigonometric functions, because it's very difficult to find this to integrate the sin square as it is. So by using the trigonometric relations, sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 theta. Sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 theta. So integration 0 to a x square, write it as it is, x square into sin square pi x by a. So sin square means 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 theta is nothing but pi x by a. So pi x divided by a into dx. Next is equal to 2 by a integration 0 to a, this 1 by 2 is a constant, take that outside, so 1 by 2, and multiply this x square inside, so inside the bracket, so we get x square into dx minus integration x square into cos 2 pi x divided by a into dx. Okay, next is equal to 2 gets cancelled, and remaining is 1 by a into integration of x square x cube by 3 limit range from 0 to a minus x square into integration of cos sin 2 pi x divided by a. Okay, so we should integrate this integration by parts, so I am going to write this here minus, so minus, I am continuing here, so minus into minus into take the x square as it is, x square into integration of cos is nothing but sine. Sine 2 pi x divided by a divided by 2 pi by a. Next, minus. So I am going to integrate here integration by parts. That means integration of uv dx is equal to u into integration of v minus differentiation of u dash into integration of this whole term. That means integration of v. And again plus differentiation of this term u double dash into integration of this whole term. That means integration of v. So like that, you have to integrate by parts. So next, minus integration of this term, okay, and differentiation of this term. Differentiation of x square is equal to 2x. Differentiation of x square is equal to 2x and integration of this term. So integration of sine is equal to cos minus cos 2 pi x divided by 2 pi by a. And also one more term is already there, 2 pi by a. So take the 2 pi by a whole square. Okay, next, again this x term is not removed. Again, one more time, you have to differentiate this term. Take plus, alternate minus. So plus integration of this x, 2, sorry, differentiation of this x is 2 into cos, integration of cos sine. So sine 2 pi x divided by pi 2 pi by a term is already there. So 2 pi by a over q. Okay, minus right side minus is added as x. Next, 0 to a. So you get is equal to 1 by a into after applying limit for x cube by 3 will get a cube. So a cube by 3 and so minus here. So just multiply minus inside, minus x square limits 0 to a. Okay, but so I am going to write one more time the same terms, minus x square sine 2 pi x divided by a, 2 pi x divided by a into 2 pi by a, okay, minus 2x into, see, minus into minus plus cos 2 pi x divided by a divided by 2 pi by a whole square and minus, so I am going to write here, okay, minus 2 sine 2 pi x divided by a into 2 pi by a whole cube. Okay, so next apply the limits 0 to a and 0 to a. Next, so is equal to 1 by a into a cube by 3 minus, so after applying its limits, so gets cancelled, because a gets cancelled, sine 2 pi is nothing but sine even pi, sine any even pi is 0, okay, sine 180 degree or sine 360 degree, so like that, so sine 0, so after applying lower limit, the term will get 0 plus 2 into a, I am going to apply the upper limit, so 2a into cos 2 pi a divided by 2 pi by a whole square minus, I am going to apply lower limit 2 into 0, so 0 into cos 0 is 1, but 0 infinity is 0, so no need to apply this lower limit, so because the term will get 0, and minus 2 into, again sine even pi and sine 0, if you apply the upper limit, a and a gets cancelled, remaining is sine 2 pi and sine 2 pi is 0, so 0, So minus 0. Okay, next. Equal to 1 by a is equal to 1 by a cube divided by 3 minus 2a minus into plus minus. So minus 2a cos 2 pi, because a gets cancelled. And cos 2 pi, that means cos 180 degree, cos 180 degree is 1. So 2a divided by, the terms is 2 pi divided by 2 pi by a whole square. 2 pi by a whole square. And which is equal to 1 by a into a cube divided by 3 minus 2a into a divided by 2 pi whole square. Okay, a divided by 2 pi whole square. Next, so which is equal to 1 by a into a cube by 3 minus a square and a cube. So 2a cube divided by 4 pi square. 2, 4, I guess cancel. Remaining is 1 by a into a cube divided by 3 minus and a cube divided by 2 pi square. Next is equal to 1 by a into, if you take the a cube outside, you get a cube, it will be 1 by 3 minus 1 divided by 2 pi square, and a cube gets cancelled. So therefore, expectation level x square for electron bound in a one dimensional potential box is square into x. Expression of x square is equal to 1 a square into 1 by 3 minus 1 divided by 2 pi square. So 2 pi square. Okay? Next one. So expectation value of p square is equal to integration 0 to a psi star p square psi dx. We know that the momentum operator p square is px square. Momentum operates electron along x axis in only one dimensional motion. So px square is equal to minus I h cross dou by dou x into minus I h cross dou by dou x. So is equal to minus into minus plus I square into I square again minus h cross into h cross square into dou square divided by dou square into px square. So px square is equal to minus h cross square dou square by dou x square. So here we have to substitute. And psi, the wave function for electron is in a 1D box is psi is equal to root 2 divided by l into sine pi x divided by a for n is equal to 1. So here I am going to discuss for n is equal to 1 ground state. Otherwise you have to take here n. So next, psi star is equal to root 2 divided by l into sine pi x divided by l. Okay, next. So now we have to apply this p square. So this is a. The box length is 0 to a, take this real a. Otherwise, the box length is 0 to l, take this real l. And here also l. So now, but here I am going to take 0 to a, so this difference into a. Okay, next. So px square is equal to integration 0 to a psi star root 2 by a. So root 2 by a into sin pi x divided by a. And the px square is nothing but minus h cross square by dou x square into sin pi x divided by a into dx. px square is equal to, so here this differential operator is operating on this wave function, the sine function, two times. Okay, so now this right here, dou pi dou x square, dou square by dou x square can be written as dou pi dou x of dou pi dou x of sine. Okay, so sine pi x divided by a, sine pi x divided by a. So a differentiation of a sine with respect to x will get cos. So dou pi dou x of cos pi x divided by a into pi by a. Next, again differentiate this cos one more time with respect to x, you get minus sin of pi x by a into pi by a. But already one more pi by a term is there, so pi by a is pi. So px square is equal to integration 0 to a root 2 by a into root 2 by a. So, root 2 by a. So root 2 by a into root 2 by a, 2 by a. Okay? So take the 2 by a constant outside and sine pi x by a, sine pi x by a into, and this take the, see, this whole term can be written as minus sin pi x by into pi by a over square. So minus h cos square, write it as it is, and again minus sin pi x divided by a into pi by a over square into dx. Next, it is equal to 2 by a integration 0 to a. See, minus into minus plus, and take that h cos square outside. So h cos square, and also this pi by a also is also constant. Take that as also outside. So pi by a whole square. Okay. So integration 0 to a sin pi x by a into sin pi x divided by a into dx. Next, so it is equal to 2 a square into a cube pi square h cross square integration 0 to a sin into sin, sin square pi x divided by a into dx, sin square pi x divided by a into dx. So is equal to 2 pi square h cross square divided by a cube. This sin square term can be written as sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 theta. So sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 theta. Next, so you can write integration 0 to a sin square pi x by a can be written as 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos theta is equal to pi x by a, 2 pi x by a into dx. Okay, next, px expression value of px square for an electron bound in a 1D box, one dimensional potential box, is px square. So here I am going to discuss for a ground state. Px square is equal to 2 pi square h cross square divided by a cube into, so integration of this dx, constant integration of this dx, okay, it is x, and take that 1 by 2 is outside. So I am going to write 2 here, I am taking that 2 outside, and multiply dx into 1. Dx into 1 is nothing but dx, and integration of dx is nothing but x. X and limits 0 to a minus integration of cos sine 2 pi x divided by a and under a by 2 pi limits is 0 to a, which is equal to 2 gets cancelled and pi square h cross square divided by a cube into a. So after applying limit, this will get 0 because sine even pi and sine 0 is equal to 0. So the answer is a into a cube gets cancelled and the new denominator will get a square. So pi square h cross square divided by a square, and this is the expectation value of p x. Okay. So in the next video we will discuss uncertainty in momentum and uncertainty in position. So uncertainty in momentum and uncertainty in position. So delta x is equal to root of expectation value of x squared, expectation value of x over square. And uncertainty in position, delta p x is equal to square root of p square x minus p x. So after substituting here, we will get uncertainty relation delta x delta x greater than or equal to h cross equal to or something that we will. Okay, so in the next video we will discuss uncertainty in position and uncertainty in momentum. So you will try it. So we already have the value of x and also x square and also px square and also px. You will try it once again and I will also discuss in the next video.